Welcome to PC Analytics. Today, we're going to dig into the differences between the Peerless Assassin 120 SE versus the Frost Commander 140. We've got our test bench right here, ready to put these coolers to the test and give you all the information you need to make the perfect choice for your setup. Both the Peerless Assassin and the Frost Commander feature dual tower designs, with the Assassin featuring 6 heat pipes, while the Commander having 5. While they each include 2 fans, the Assassin has a pair of 120mm fans, and the Commander combines a 120mm fan in the front with a 140mm fan in the middle. The Frost Commander showcases a clean top, as opposed to the exposed heat pipes on the Peerless Assassin SE, and the Commander is also wider to accommodate the larger 140mm fan. However, we know you're here to see how these two coolers differ in terms of performance, so let's dig into it. We've tested both coolers over idle, high, and overclock temperatures, and have two sets of charts to show you. One that looks at performance normalized by percent speeds, and one that looks at performance normalized by sound. In our first set of charts normalized by percent speeds, we have temperatures on the left represented by the solid line, noise on the right represented by the dashed line, and percent speeds on the bottom. For this graph, lower is always better. At idle, the Peerless Assassin in red has similar performance as the Frost Commander in blue, with comparable noise levels under 40% fan speed. However, as we increase the wattage to 105 watts, we can observe that the Frost Commander begins to outperform in terms of cooling. However, this is at the cost of materially louder noise levels above 50% fan speed. And as we push the CPU to overclock levels of 125 watts, the Frost Commander widens its cooling performance lead. In our second set of charts normalized by sound, we have temperatures on the left, noise on the bottom, with lower being better. At idle, the coolers continue to perform similarly, and as we increase the wattage to 105 watts, we can see that the Frost Commander provides better cooling for a given noise level. And even when we push the CPU to its limits at 125 watts, this performance trend continues. And if you're curious on how the Peerless Assassin SE compares to the regular Peerless Assassin, you should check out this video comparing these two coolers. You might be surprised by their differences. Thanks for watching, and if you found value in this content, I invite you to support this channel by hitting that like button or subscribing. Your support is appreciated.